Testify together with the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. As we await the start of the hearing, lots of anticipation. Let's bring in two guests. The former Republican presidential candidate, former Congressman Ron Paul is joining us. Also Democratic Congressman Mike Quigley of Illinois. Congressman Paul, first to you. You are totally, correct me if I'm wrong, totally opposed to any U.S. military force in Syria right now, despite all of that evidence that the Syrian regime used chemical weapons against its own people. Is that right?
Yeah, but I don't accept your statement because I think that a lot of people question some of that evidence. But I don't need, that is beside the point because of the policy that I advocate is a non-interventionist foreign policy. I don't believe it's in our interest. I don't believe it's our national security best interest to be involved. I don't think it's legal under national law or international law. I think just killing more people because he has killed some people, if that is the case, doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So a non-interventionist doesn't pretend that they are all wise, that they can go into a country that's been in civil war, where there's several different factions fighting and killing each other, Christians getting killed by rebels, and the Assad regime being blamed for doing this and that. I don't believe it's capable, morally, nor are we able to go in and say, oh, we know who the good guys are. We know there's three different groups on the rebels, but we know that we won't give any help to the Al-Qaeda. We just have to punish Assad. It's a civil war, and there's no way you're going to figure it out. I smell Iraq all over again. I remember the assurances that were given us 10 years ago, and members of Congress believe that. But let me tell you, the situation is a lot different. The American people are on my side on this issue today, and there's a lot more people in Congress now are saying it makes no sense. And just listen to the military commanders. They said, you know, we don't even have the money for this. We have to have a supplemental. Now, how about all these warmongers getting ready to bomb and kill and invade or do whatever they think necessary, and they don't even have the money, and then they have to appropriate the money, which means more money drained from our economy. So the policy of a non-intervention, as a matter of fact, it's pretty easy. We just mind our own business, take care of America, and obey the law and obey the Constitution. Then you don't have to pretend, oh, I know how bad Assad is, and I know that he's a little bit worse than the Al-Qaeda, so let's go on the side of the Al-Qaeda. It makes no sense whatsoever to us.
All right. Congressman Ron Paul, totally, totally opposed to any U.S. involvement in Syria, and doesn't necessarily even believe the President of the United States, the Secretary of State, when they say they have high confidence that the Syrians did, in fact, use chemical weapons against their own people. Congressman Quigley, give us your reaction. You think Ron Paul is right, or do you think President Obama is right?
Well, let me just say this. It is clear to me after being briefed that there are gas attacks took place and that the Assad regime was responsible. The question is, what do we do now? I have every faith in the administration was honest and forthright about that process. This is an extraordinarily messy sectarian struggle. It is not exactly clear to me at this point that our involvement will help the situation and perhaps not create unintended consequences. So I think there are serious questions to be answered, but trust in the administration isn't one of those.
Ron Paul, as you take a look at what's going on, and you know, there's going to be a huge debate that begins within the next few minutes in the Senate before the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. The House is going to take up all of these matters. There'll be floor debates, close votes, I assume, in both the House and the Senate. We know how you would vote if you were still a member, but why is it that so many Republicans, including John McCain, Lindsey Graham, and others, they not only want the president to go ahead and launch strikes against targets inside Syria, but they want to go even further than what the president says he wants to do. These are members of your own party. Why is there this serious split between those, shall we say, more libertarian isolationist types, non-interventionist types like you and your son, Senator Rand Paul, and people like John McCain and Lindsey Graham?
Well, I think people are waking up. There's been a Tea Party movement, a grassroots movement. The young people in the Congress, the newer members are on our side on this. Just take a look at the bipartisan support we got for trying to rein in NSA. That was Democrats and Republicans, but sort of grassroots. And the leadership at both levels, they want the NSA and all this spying going on. This is what's going to happen on this vote. Leadership will probably get together and get some sort of authority passed for the president to try to make him feel better or something. But how many people does he have to kill to feel better because he drew a line in the sand or had this red line? I mean, what was the purpose of all that? Nobody knows why we're going in there, and nobody's sure who are the good guys and the bad guys. But the people are waking up. They remember 10 years ago. They remember, and they witness the results today of what's going on in Iraq. Now, even some people in Iraq are saying, well, do not go in there and bomb because we're going to help Assad. Some of the Shia wants to come in. You know, al-Sadr wants to go in and help him. So this thing could easily spread. But who created Iraq? We did. It's our country. And now they're aligned with the Iranians. So the whole theory is that we're going into Syria because that's the way you march into Iran. At the same time, we've made it tougher. We've made it tougher for Israel. We've made it tougher for the people who want to live in peace in Iraq. And now we're just stirring it up in Syria. It's a civil war. We don't have the authority. And the vote in England, the British vote in the parliament, that is fantastic. First time since 1782.
Ron Paul,
the people are getting in charge.
I got to wrap it up, but I just want to clarify one point. You're not blaming the United States for the civil war in Syria over the past 2.5 years that have already resulted more than 100,000 people dead.